take your stress away. Ballin' like every day. Call me coach, gotta switch up plays. Spend a little money, don't care how it's made. Drop top, cool, catch sun rays. Started off with attic, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick, and she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you a demon. I get the money for real no reason. Why everybody come through unpolitely? I ride around in exotic. Wake me up, cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this. I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to give me away. Ain't nobody helping. I was friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I'm on it.
It's the coach with you here today, and this is an ultimate challenge.
Ready for football now.
I told everybody to send 115 for like a total of gas to get down there, ground down there, and back up there. So like when we pay for a rental, it's not really gonna be 6 months. When you pay for it, you really wanna get 240 times two. 480. That's how much you're gonna get when you pay for it. Now the extra shit, that's like just gas and like sales. So you may not even spend like a full 600 even with gas. That was just to make sure that everyone's cool. And like how great it's about to fold, you would have still had enough to get the rental even if he didn't make it, one person didn't make it to the shit. So really think like it's through there for him.
But she would have slipped it.
I just need to go make $80 to $90 a day for a studio. So I'm gonna stay on track with this shit, since you kinda set me back with this business shit. Cause that's anything I gave you wasn't even what I told y'all. Depressed about your birthday's not even here. You had a whole year to think about what you wanted. You had a year to think about what you wanted to do. You tried to wait till the last minute.
You see what happened?
Tattoos the last door.
Yeah.
Like we can get a rental and drive to Chicago. You want to go?
No, I don't care to. That's gonna be too much money. I'm not gonna
do anything.
But
so like, what would be your option?
I don't have any options.
So you just want to get
tattoos? Yeah, I'm gonna go to the mall, do some shopping, spend money on myself, probably get a car.
She got them big old Teddy's.
You got them big old Teddy's babies.
Yeah. I'm just gonna email the motherfuckers
after we come back. try to go to work Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday if I can.
And off we go from Lambeau. The return man is Grant. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Up to midfield. The 30. 10. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, 49ers. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him, kick it to him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown, as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. Veteran Green Bay quarterback Aaron Rodgers ready to go for drive number one along with the rest of this Packer offense. Rodgers now on first down. This one swung out to Williams. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, just inside the 30. Rodgers gonna throw. Funches with a catch over the middle.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Flush to his right. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for, but this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
From the 40 now on second down, Rodgers. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 46. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9. Rodgers now to throw. Open man is Winfrey. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. After 1-7-0, Audie Sports.
That booty's fat. You said you got that fat butt. That's what you said. With that fat, fat, fat.
A good chance this is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. From the gun, it's Rodgers. To be able to convert, and I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point, and they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
The left side throw complete to Adams. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first, thanks to a flashy little spin move. Now it's Rodgers. He goes right back to Adams. That's complete. Touchdown, Packers! Devontae Adams, 33 yards. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Crosby connects on the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Grant sets to return it. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They're led by their six-year quarterback out of North Dakota State, a former Pro Bowler, Carson Wentz. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. Coming up in a couple of minutes' time, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. He'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. And he gets this to the other side of midfield, across the 45 before going out.
Good, strong, explosive run that started inside, which means you've got to control those defensive linemen, the defensive tackles, the nose guards. Those guys have to be controlled. How about the offensive line, the job they just did?
Yeah, key that A-gap usually on those runs, right?
That's where it all starts, because everyone wants to kind of control that area. It disrupts things from the defensive side and the offensive side. As we just saw, it opens up possibilities.
You want to go to the dentist?
On first down.
That's HBO money right there.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
See, I can use that one.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football.
Push that shit back. You already know
them. Room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
On second down, Johnson, and he gets it down to the 32.
Now it's health over fun.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and 2.
Now I'm going to pick up a first down.
They ran it and picked it up.
Where was that energy at a year ago?
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. They'll run on first down. It's Johnson. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Suckup will put this one right through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7.
Shit. You said something about that ass.
Good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the time, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past
it. And good coverage there on special teams.
My fucker, Jigga. Motherfucker throw it, man. Cold as hell out there. But
about set to get this
drive
started.
Get the fuck out of here with that shit.
Offense at the line. And they'll take over with just 16 ticks remaining before intermission. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. And just like that, on we head to half number 2. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action. Ready for the third quarter. This fielded right at the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. He'll hand this to Williams to start things out. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
But sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the improv and you run into a tough crowd.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
Here's Jones. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Lambeau Field, one of the best home field advantages in the NFL, no doubt. And they're a happy bunch here as the Packers lead third quarter.
Fuck.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Rodgers now on first down.
Come on, man. Get this fucking nigga, man.
Pick up of 8, second and 2.
Fuck. Let's get this nigga. This nigga keep hitting in the middle.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the short catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Now a throw here,
Fuck.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Less than 2 to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18.
Come on, man. We need a pick, man. We need a pick, man.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
On second down, it's Jones.
Stop letting this nigga get the first down, bro.
So a gain of 9.
What the
line here, but remember, it's also third down. Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's gonna wind up incomplete.
That means it's just 1 last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
The kick by Crosby is good.
Damn,
we are all tied here in the final stages. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. They need to get this around the 40 to have a chance to win it in regulation. From the 40, it's a 57-yard field goal, so that gives you a gauge.
And all they're trying to do now is pick up yardage in good chunks and get out of bounds to stop the clock. If they end up running a play and get tackled in bounds, they're worried the clock may run out on them and finish the game.
And they'll have to be careful how they handle this. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Johnson on the counter. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They go to Johnson again. And a short gain down to about the 33. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So third down, and a field goal from here would be right about 50 yards as they try to get closer. They'll hand it off now, Johnson. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Oh, no, boy.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They run. It's Johnson. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. 63 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And the 49ers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll run it with Johnson. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
Well, any thoughts about overtime?
Huh?
Have ended at this juncture.
You said what?
Touchdown puts them up 6. I would imagine they'll kick the extra point now and rely on their defense.
Yeah, rely on their defense. So a little bit of time left on the clock here in the fourth, but they got to feel good now.
You say you hungry?
Put through by Suckup, and that makes it a 17-10 score.
The oven's on.
So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. So now Rodgers in the pack, trailing 17-10, 27 seconds to go. They've got to travel the full 75 yards, and time is obviously a huge factor here. First and 10. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
To throw is Rodgers. Pass complete, Tonyan. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. There you have it, another challenge and another victory. Now remember, you can always replay challenges if you left any stars on the table.
Everybody, welcome. It's the coach with you here today for another edition of Madden Ultimate Team. To finish this out, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. Here comes Grant on the return. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They're led by their six-year quarterback out of North Dakota State, a former Pro Bowler, Carson Wentz.
And when you look at him, you see that he's got all the tools you want in a quarterback. The big frame, the quick release, strong arm, has escapability. The issue sometimes, tries to do too much instead of just taking the throws that are available to him, and occasionally turnovers get him into trouble.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. The last run got six, now second and four. The gun, a run for Johnson, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
A first down carry here for Johnson, and able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's gonna bring up second and 11.
The job of any linebacker involves having enough strength to fight off a blocker and get to ball carriers. But in this case, I think we can safely say he beat him right off the snap to get into the backfield and make that play.
That's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Dean. And the Bucs are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. Suckup, the man tasked with getting this one started. And off we go from Tampa. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. And the offense readies for a first down and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
So a pretty early first quarter roughing the passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
A handoff to Fournette. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Yeah, they stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and 9, Brady. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They're led by their six-year quarterback out of North Dakota State, a former Pro Bowler, Carson Wentz.
And when you look at him, you see
have
that
no
he's
money.
Got all the tools you want in a quarterback. The big frame, the quick release, strong arm, has escapability. The issue sometimes tries to do too much instead of just taking the throws that are available to him, and occasionally turnovers get him into trouble.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. On play action, it's Wentz. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Wentz Allworth, 53 yards. And the Rams on just two plays have taken the lead. Extra point up and good by Suckup. And that makes the score 7-0. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. Now it's Ryan Suckup on after the touchdown to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. And here we go again with Tom Brady in Tampa's offense. And he'll look to rebound from the early interception that led to 6 points the other way.
And when he threw the interception and he had to come to the sideline, I guarantee his first thought wasn't about the interception itself, but what could result. And I know he was thinking to himself, come on, defense, bail me out. Well, they weren't able to in this situation. Now he's got to go out and atone for it himself, but he can't force things.
On second and 9, Brady into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it. So they've got the football, and they'll start right on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And, Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them, and they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now Johnson, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. after one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a 3rd and 4. They run the counter. Johnson, and able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
So it's pretty simple, partner. You pick up a turnover, set you up in excellent field position. The last thing you want to do is go 3 and out in this spot.
Yeah, they would have had to settle for a field goal attempt, but now they keep those touchdown hopes alive. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. On 2nd down now, it's Johnson. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's 3rd and goal. Suckup on after the touchdown to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. Bottom line, he's got to figure things out. He's completed 3 passes, but 2 of them have been to the wrong team so far.
And when we talk about the best quarterbacks, we're usually talking about touchdown to interception ratio, aren't we?
And Brady going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off near the 26. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Shotgun now for Wentz. He finds his man complete. It's Grant. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. Working from the gun, Wentz. Throw left side complete. That's Cook. And the Rams are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Here's 1st and goal, and gosh, points here, a chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1. Before halftime, excellent. extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now 21 to nothing. Just a four-play drive that time. And it ends with a one-yard touchdown run. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And we'll see what they opt to do with just 14 seconds remaining until intermission. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. So two quarters dead, an abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. The return man is Graham, and he's going to be out of bounds on the return way back at the 11. The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number three. The first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it. And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. First and 10, here's Wentz. DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
On second down, Johnson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. From the gun, it's Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Carson Wentz. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Rams take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And it is 28-0. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust? And the Rams got him. They bring him down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. To throw is Brady. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Vaughn.
Going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass.
Really well done.
Throwing is Brady on third down. This one swung out to Vaughn. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. Now Brady, gotta have this one. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And now defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And he's got Gronkowski yet again. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, Brady. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Throwing on first down is Brady. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Brady to throw. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with an even 90 seconds remaining on the clock. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Looking downfield for Godwin. That went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Kyle Fuller.
So many times we end a game, and as we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over. The defense, they frustrated the offense the entire ball game. That's why they're walking out of here with a victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it. Wentz to throw. Going deep for Hopkins. He's got a man complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it to the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Extra point up and good by Succop, and that will extend this big lead. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Brian Arakpo comes in hot for the sack.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Brady. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
And just like that, another ultimate challenge has been